In this discussion, we look at the northwest corner rule, which is one of many methods that can be used to find the initial feasible solution of transportation problems. We will start by looking at the algorithm. The starting point is to select the cell that is at the northwest position. Then, after selecting that cell, you want to allocate the maximum allowable quantity to that cell by taking into consideration the supply capacity and the demand capacity. So whatever you allocate to the cell at the northwest corner, the total must not, that quantity must not exceed the supply capacity or the demand requirement. So from the initial allocation, you can either go to the right across the row to exhaust the supply, or you can go down along a column to exhaust the demand. So if you wanted to exhaust the supply, then you have to go to the right. So to move to the right, you must allocate enough units to exhaust the capacity on that row before go down to another row. If the row has been exhausted, then you want to make sure that also the demand is also exhausted. You make an allocation to the cell in such a way that the total does not exceed the demand requirement. So basically, with this algorithm, you just move from one cell either to the right or down, go to the right or down, to the right or down. What determines that you move to the right is the supply requirement. If you move downwards, you are considering the demand requirements. So you repeat this algorithm until all the demand and supply requirements have been met. That is, the problem is now balanced. So let us look at an example which illustrates how this algorithm is implemented. It's easy to explain the algorithm through an example. So here you have a transportation table with two rows and three columns, meaning that you have two supply points and three demand destinations. So the starting point is to select the northwest corner, which for this example is this cell. Then you allocate the maximum amount to this cell by considering the demand and the supply. So the maximum that can be allocated to this cell is 10. So which means that once you've allocated 10, then you can't allocate anything to this cell, because if you add anything on this cell, any amount on this cell, then the total will be more than 10, which means that the demand requirement has been exceeded. You want it to be exactly equal. So you can only go to the right now and try to allocate the maximum amount to the next cell so that this supply requirement is met. So the maximum that you can allocate there, if you consider 30 and 20 and 40 plus this 10, it means that the maximum that you can allocate there would be, in an effort to exhaust the supply on the row, the maximum is 20. So this row is now full, so which means that you need to go down to exhaust the demand requirement. So the maximum that you can allocate now to this cell is 20, and because 20 plus 20 now is 40, so which means that this column is also balanced. So then the last allocation has got to be made on this cell. So the maximum you can allocate there is 70. So note that everything now balances. The row, if you add the allocations, they add up to 10. If you add on the second column, they add up to 40. On the third column, they add up to 70. Similarly, on the first row, adding the allocations, you add up to 30. And on the second row, the allocations add up to 70. So that's what we mean by a balanced transportation problem. Next, we look at a problem with three supply points and three demand destinations. So the starting point is to select the northwest corner and make a maximum allocation. The maximum allocation that can be made is 80, because when you compare this 80 and 120, so the maximum you can make there on that cell is 80, meaning that now this column is full, so you have to go to the right, make an allocation on this cell. So the maximum you can allocate there is 80, because when you want this row to balance, so because the total is 160 and you had allocated 80, then it means the maximum you can allocate would be 80. So then you can not allocate anything more on this cell. So then the next step means that in the next step, you want to go down and make a maximum allocation there. So the maximum allocation would be 80, because you want the total there to balance with that 80. So which means that this cell is now full. Then you can only go right and make a maximum allocation there. You compare 160 and 250, and then the maximum allocation that you can make would be, because you already have 200 there, so it means the maximum allocation that you can make on that cell is 50, so that the total adds up to 250. Then the final step, you can only go down. So if you go down and make a maximum allocation there by comparing this 110 and 160, bearing in mind that you already have a 50 on that cell, so the maximum you can place there is 110. So now everything balances. The total in first column is 80, second column 280, third column 160, first row 160, 250, and 110. So now if we look at the total cost now of this allocation, you first note that the routes that are occupied are A to 1, which is this route, A to 2, that route, B to 2, this route, B to 3, that route, and C to 3 is this route. Then the cost of each route, total cost of each route, is obtained by multiplying the allocation, which is the number of units, with the cost per unit. So for example, the total cost of this allocation is 3, which is the cost per unit, times the number of units, which is 110. So it's 3 times 110, so that is 330. So if you calculate the total costs in for all the routes, and you add them up, you get the total cost of this allocation. The last example, the next example, we consider a table with four supply points and four demand points. So make an allocation on the northwest corner. That's the northwest corner. Allocate the maximum amount, 30. So this cell is now full. You can go right. Maximum allocation you can make there is 140. This cell, this column is now full. You can't go down. You can, which means you have to continue adding across the row until everything adds up to 190. So the maximum that you can add now to this cell would be 20. So that the total is now 190, and then which means that this cell you can't allocate anything on that cell. Then you have to go down, going down, allocate the maximum amount. Now you're comparing 40 and 90, so the maximum that you can place on this cell is 40. So which means that this cell you can't allocate anything on that cell. Then you have to go down and allocate as much as possible to this cell, but not exceeding 90 when you count the total in the column, and 220 when you count the total in the row. So the maximum you can allocate is 30. When you allocate 30, it means that this cell is now you cannot allocate anything on this cell, so you have to go right, allocate as much as possible so that the total is 220, so 8190. Then in the last step, you allocate on the last row, so there you have to allocate 70 to make sure that everything adds up to 70. So everything you can just check, if you the columns add up to 30, 140, 90, 260, and the row 190, 40, 220, and 70. So the problem is now balanced, and the total cost of this allocation is 2,950, which can be obtained by adding the products between the cost per unit on each cell times the number of units allocated to that particular cell.